Hello everyone, I am Professor S. N. Mane, Assistant Professor, Department of Processing and Food Engineering, working in KKWA College of Agriculture Engineering and Technology, Nashik. Today we will learn about HACCP. So first of all, we will see what is HACCP. HACCP, it is a Hazard Analysis Critical Control Point and it is a food safety management system. So what it do that it identifies, evaluate and control the different hazards which are significant for the food safety. So here we will see a food safety in the early 21st century. It is an international challenge which is requiring close cooperation between the countries in agreeing standard and setting up transnational surveillance system. The behavior of different consumers has been gradually changing. They currently require not only much higher dietary quality, hygiene and the health standards in the products they purchase, but they also look for the certification and the reassurance of the products and their production methods. So we will see some history about HACCP. HACCP is known as Hazard Analysis Critical Control Point, which is developed in the 1960s in the United States in order to ensure the food safety for the first manned National Aeronautics and the Space Administration space missions. Okay, those peoples which are working in the NASA, these peoples, it requires the food which is free from any harm, or it is assured food which should be required by these peoples. So it required some zero defect program in order to guarantee the safety in related to the foods which are astronauts which get consumed that kind of food in the space. So the Pillsbury company, which is presenting this HACCP system at the National Food Protection Conference in 1971. So these concept, it is initially came into force by the Pillsbury company, which is supplying food to the peoples for the NASA. Now, so and nowadays, this HACCP system, it is continuously and compulsory working in any food processing industry. Now, different prerequisite programs we will learn. First of all, building and equipment design. Any food processing industry, it should require a particular neat and proper building and the equipment design. Then facility of the cleaning and sanitation, see here, source of water supply for the cleaning and the sanitization, these are also very important facility and it is a very important prerequisite program. Then proper facilities like storage facilities and service facilities like cold and dry chemicals, then potable water, then ventilation facilities. So these facilities should be provided by that industry. Then personal hygiene regarding their hand washing and the good hygiene habits like personal maintenance. So all these things, these are some prerequisite programs. Also along with that, maintenance, then waste management. See, this waste management, it is very important. Then pest control system. Okay, most of the industries which having the chances of different pests and insects, so their management or their control is very important. Then approved suppliers, then supply of different vehicles, then staff training. Whatever peoples are working in that, they should be trained, they should be suggested by, or it should be provided with the certain training program so that they will work properly in that industry with the proper care. Then operational controls regarding the policy, procedures and the work instruction. All these things, these are very important or important programs related to the any food processing industry. Now we will see different principles of the HACCP. First of all, conduct hazard analysis. It is the first principle. Then determine critical control point. then establish their critical limits, establish monitoring system, then establish corrective action, then establish verification process, procedure, and establish documentation. So one by one, we will see individual principle of the HACCP. So first of all, we will see the hazard analysis. Conduct a hazard analysis means what we have to do. We have to identify the hazard and how it will affect on your food products. So make identification of which kind of hazard it may be there. It may be physical, chemical, or biological. TL. We have already covered in previous lectures of the food hazards, that is which kind of physical hazards are there, like metallic parts, broken glass, hairs, bones, like that. Then different chemicals like chemical pesticides, then hormones, okay, then different fertilizers, okay, all these things are the cleaning chemicals, maintenance chemicals, agriculture chemicals, okay, and coloring agents. These are the some chemical hazards. Then biological hazards. Biological hazards means some microorganism like bacteria, mold, and yeast. All these things comes under the biological hazard. So we have to identify which kind of hazard is that. Then second is the critical control point. Now by identifying that hazard, which we have to make the control of that hazard. That is, how you can eliminate or how you can reduce that kind of hazard. So that things you have to consider, which step we have to make in order to control these kind of hazards, in order to their prevention, elimination, and reduction of that hazards. Up to acceptable level, we have to make the control points. Okay. See, this is the decision tree regarding the physical, chemical, and biological hazard. We will see, we will take some example of any kind of food product like milk. Suppose physical hazard present in the milk like dust particle or foreign matter. So suppose filtration process we are going to be followed. So is this process, it is applicable for the removal of the physical hazard? So it is yes. Okay, in case of physical hazard, this filtration process, it is applicable because by filtration we can remove that kind of things. But for the chemical hazard, suppose chemical hazard like chemical pesticides, suppose in the milk how it comes from the fodder, so that chemical hazards it will come into the milk through the fodder. So these chemical hazard we cannot remove by the filtration process. Okay, so this decision tree, filtration process, it is not applicable for the chemical hazards. Got the point? Then in case of biological hazard, see, biological hazard present in the milk like bacteria, microorganism like bacteria, yeast, or mold. Bacteria comes due to the improper sanitization of the udder of the animals. In that case, or not proper hygiene will be maintained by the milking person. In that case, microorganism get entered into your milk. So this microorganism or this kind of biological hazard, it cannot be get detected or eliminated by the filtration process. So this kind of decision tree will be used for the deciding critical control point. For that biological hazard, we have to apply another thing, that is pasteurization process or the sterilization process. Okay, like that. Then second one is the critical, third has a principle is the critical limits. So here in the critical limit, as per the identification of that kind of hazard, we have to decide a particular limit for that hazard. Means suppose for the biological hazard, we have to set a proper temperature for destruction of that kind of microorganism and time. So time and temperature combination should be for the biological hazards. Then for the physical hazards, in case of filtration process, we have to decide the maximum residue level in case of chemical hazards. Okay, so their limit we have to decide. Okay, what should be the maximum level and minimum level as per the type of hazard and type of commodity. So that is the critical limit principle. Then second, fourth principle is the monitoring system. Once you have decided the critical limit, whether it works properly or not, so we have to check. We have to make the monitorizing system such that it will give the proper control regarding that measures. Okay, so that will not be exceeded. We have to check whether that in case of biological hazard, suppose in case of pasteurization process, this temperature and time combination should not be get exceed or should not be get minimized. It should be proper. So we have to check that things by the monitorizing system. Then corrective action. Now, if by through the monitoring system, suppose you have identified regarding a particular hazard that these kind of things are not properly get maintained in that process, means that proper time temperature is not maintained, or their chemical hazard level it not get properly maintained, that is their maximum residue level it is not that much optimum. In that case, we have to take the decision regarding that critical limit. Okay, that either we have to transfer that product for the next process or we have to discard. This action we have to take in the corrective action principle. Next one is the verification process. By this process, we have to verify your HACCP plan. It is working properly or not. We have to cross-verify with the other things. And last one is the documentation. Whatever records you are going to be take throughout this principles or throughout this unit operation, in that condition, you have to make the record of everything. Right from the raw material reception, then initial screening of your raw material and end product screening, then temperature charts, cleaning schedules, then pest control record, equipment maintenance record, training records, all the things you have to record. You have to keep their documentations. Okay. So that your HACCP will work properly. So in this lecture, we learn what is meant by HACCP, what is HACCP, What is the history behind the HACCP? Then what is the different principles of the HACCP? We will learn here. Thank you.